It's the biggest story in the world of sports. Kobe Bryant's getting a divorce. I'm here in Encino, California, talking to ballers who are Laker fans. But what would you tell Kobe that he's getting a divorce? Any message for him?
Good luck. Congratulations. Have fun.
No, it's not a fun thing to get a divorce.
There's no such thing as bad news as a divorce.
Why?
Everybody who's getting a divorce is always happy about it.
You think so?
There's one side of it. Probably it's not happy.
I mean, it's not good always, you know. It's tough.
Honestly, man, I think there's so much going on with Chris Paul and the whole deal that got smashed up, and then Lamar Odom getting traded for nothing. And this is the first news I've heard about Kobe getting divorced. But if that's true, then, you know, I think the Lakers got some problems this year. I think that either they do make a big move for Dwight Howard, they're going to go back into rebuilding mode.
Let me ask you, what do you say, Jay?
Man, I think, honestly, they're going to win another ring, unfortunately.
The Lakers?
Yeah.
Even the Clippers have Chris Paul, and they have the earthquake, Blake Griffin.
Look, Blake Griffin's been injured for a whole season before. I hope nothing bad on him, but it could happen again.
You're jinxing the Clippers right now.
I'm just saying. But when you look at the Lakers, they're going to get Dwight Howard. You still have Kobe.
They're not going to get Dwight Howard.
Who cares? Kobe's going to score 50 points a game regardless, and that's halfway to your victory. So the Lakers are definitely getting one more ring.
Coming from a true...
You're mad at the NBA for blocking that trade and giving him to the Clippers?
Yeah. Honestly, David Stern's a little... Don't want you to blink me out on TV. Very upset with David Stern.
Daniel, do you agree with him? He said Lakers are getting a ring?
Well, coming from a true Laker fan, there's never been a season where Kobe scored 50 points a game, first of all. Second of all, unless the Lakers make a big move for, like, Dwight Howard or something like that and fill up their holes nicely, then...
But for who?
Bynum.
If I was in the Lakers' shoes...
Send Bynum away.
If I was in a...
Are you a Laker fan?
Hey, I don't like Bynum. I like Kobe. I like Kobe. I like Artes. I like Kobe.
Artes is the best.
I like Artes.
What's his new name?
Meta World Peace. If I was in Mitch Kupchak's shoes, I would give up Gasol and Bynum for Dwight Howard. Because the Lakers, they need to get younger. Otherwise, the team's going to fall apart, and they're going to be a lottery team for however many years it takes until they can land some picks.
So what he's saying is, Kobe, we need one more ring. Kobe, one more. Just one more ring. I think
they got to get Dwight Howard to give Kobe another chance. He's got to get more rings than Michael.
But you know, the Clippers also got Chauncey Billups, another leader, so they have two.
The Clippers are going to be good.
They're going to be a decent team. They're definitely going to be decent. It sucks they got rid of Gordon, but, you know, they're going to definitely be a decent team. I mean... If Blake Griffin doesn't get hurt, then he might average a double-double.
Hey, are you guys going to root for the Clippers, too?
If the Clippers are playing, the Lakers are not playing, I will root for the Clippers. My prediction is that the Clippers will lose to the Lakers in 6 in the Western Conference Finals in the playoffs.
Good prediction.
I don't know about that.
You don't know about that?
I don't think so.
So that's it. So you say Lakers, a lot of drama these days.
Yeah.
And Lamar Odom for nothing, huh?
Lamar Odom for nothing. That sucks, actually.
Why do they do that?
They must have some type of plan. They gotta have some type of plan.
All right, we'll see.
They're gonna use the trade exception and the draft pick to get somebody, hopefully.
There you have it. Stay tuned for more on Encino for ESPN3Point.com. I'm Melly Sekback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Sekback.